Okay, so all of my services are running now. Planning service is up, RMI is up, Apache is up, and even your SBase is also up. Okay, now to log into your planning application, I'm logging through my logon.jsp file. Okay, so in this, ours is Asia application which we have created. This was a non-currency application. In non-currency application, how many standard dimensions will be having? 6 standard dimensions: account, entity, scenario, version, year, and period. These are the standard dimensions we have in your non-currency application. Today, our interest is to create a currency application. Okay. So for that, what should we have? We should have a separate database, and we should have a separate user file. So I'll say create table space Asia cur, and say CU, because this is a currency application. I am saying Asia cur data file, it should be in my E directory, and that it should be present in Asia folder, right? We have anything called Asia or comp Asia on the Asia. Let us create it into Asia. The DBF file will be Asia CURR DBF. Size 30 MB. In case increases, auto extend on. Okay. Next, create user Asia cur identified by password default table space is Asia cur. Okay, and finally grant DBA to Asia. Okay, first I'll execute this, with which the user kit default tables. Your tablespace dot is getting created, then your user with access on this particular table space is getting created, and what type of access you should be having? You should be having database administration access. All these three things we have provided. Next thing what we need to do is we need to create a data source name. From where we can create a data source name? From here, two areas we can create. One is from your appwizard.jsp, and other one is through workspace also we can create. So tell me from where we want to create your the data source name or creating application. Let us do it from workspace, because yesterday we have seen how to create it from your logon.jsp. Okay, I think I didn't start my workspace agents. So to start my workspace agents, these are my two workspace agents which I need to start. I'll start this workspace agent and I'll start another workspace agent. So immediately it will not open up. It might take some time after starting your workspace services. minimum it will take 5 minutes after you start your process. Due to load and due to many other factors, they get stopped. So generally, we can't say due to mostly due to load, they get stopped. Mostly number of users connecting to the database. Due to that, it might get stopped. You can, but it will not be the correct thing. So it will be a different thing. But mostly due to load, your services will go down. So by default, the username is admin and the password is password. So to create your new planning application, to define your data source, from where we will be defining, we will have a button called as navigate. In that, we will be defining something called as classical. Make your planning work, at least you should have 3 GB of only dedicated to your VMware. Okay, otherwise it will be very slow. Otherwise don't use this workspace, just try to create it from planning interface only. So I'll go into this navigate and in this and select administrator, and from here classical application administrator, and in this I'll select planning administrator. Whenever I select planning administrator, it will open this page. So now I want to create a data source for this. So I'll say manage data source. Okay, I'll say create new data source. So the data source name will be Asia Curve. And from where it has to pull? It has to pull from Oracle. All metadata has to be stored into your Oracle. And the server name will be Verma. The database name would be OR CL. Username is Asia Curve. And password is password. Validate my database connection. So the database connection from your currency planning application to Oracle database is set. Next option is I'll be setting my Sbase related information. Sbase is also on the same server, so my server name will not change, and username would be admin and password would be password. Okay, so I'll say validate my Sbase database connection. It says the Sbase connection was successful. Now I'll say finish. With this, your data source has been created, but you don't have any application registered besides it. Select this, say create. When I say create application, it starts creating my application. I can see Asia Curve, and I can also see CR, because CR is the data source which is not using any application. So these two things are free, but I use my Asia Curve. My application name would be Asia Curve 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. I can give another character. Where should it be registered? It has to be registered under default application groups, and I'll be using business groups. Now when I come to calendar, 12 months, and my start year would be say 2008, and after that when I come to currency, I'll be selecting yes option. When I select yes, what is your application currency? Means what all currencies should be converted to your application currency. Say USD is my reporting currency also, I can say reporting currency. So all my Indian currency, USR currency, Canada currency should be converted to USD currency. So such a currency is called as application currency or reporting currencies. Indian currency, Pakistan, or any other currencies, what we say them as functional currencies. they are functional in their entities. USD is not functional in India. No one knows what US dollar is. Mostly we know only rupees. So we call Indian currency as functional currency in India. But Indian currency has to be reported to some other business in US. So then how they do transaction? They convert this INR to USD and they give that dollars to the US. Say for example, we have purchased some nuclear weapons from US. If you pay them in rupees, will they take it? They will not take it. They will always take in dollars only. So for that, you have to do that currency. So where you are paying to USD. That is your reporting currency. Okay? Now. Yes. Everything will be same. Say, I'll say plan types. When I say plan types, initially we have taken only single plan type, but in this application, let us take two plan types. So let me say Asia expense, Asia revenue. I want to record expense in one database and I also want to record revenue one in another database. And I'll say next. This is the summarized information that we have. So it says Asia Curry is our application name, data source is this, and apart from that, shared services project where it is getting registered, what type of instance you are using, what type of calculation module you are using, time period, physical start year, physical start month, number of years, weekly distribution we have taken as even, default application currency USD, support for multiple currency, yes it will support, and standard plan types, Asia expense and Asia revenue. And apart from that, workforce planning not selected, capital expense planning not selected. So if I say finish, it starts creating my planning application. My planning application will be available. Application point of view, I'll be able to see under my application list. If I say refresh, it will display Asia currency. No, there won't be currency applications, there are also non-currency applications. US law business better, what you want to convert in US? No. Okay, this is Asia currency. But if you see your database is not getting created, why is your database not getting created? Means only application will be created. So it says you have created your application. Now if I want to open my existing application, Asia application, file, open, applications, planning applications, in this it has to show Asia currency. It is not showing, just let us say refresh. File, open, applications, planning. Now you are able to see Asia currency. When I click on this, it will open my planning application. So I am opening my Asia currency application. From here, I will also open my Asia application. So that you have Asia currency and Asia application. Which is a currency application, this is a non-currency application. Both we are able to see side by side. So if I select this. Now, in this I want to create a database. What is the step I will be doing? Administrator, manage database, database. First time in your lifetime what we will do, we will hit create. From next time onwards, we will not use create. Now, if I refresh my database list, I will be able to see expense and I will be able to see revenue databases. Two databases I am able to see. And at the same time, now what I'll do is, okay, I'll open this SAL outline and I'll open my expense outline. Let us organize them vertically. Now if you see, this is your standard dimension, sorry, this is your non-currency application and this is your currency application. If you see, in your non-currency application, you are having 6 standard dimensions. You are having 6 standard dimensions. And when I come to a currency application, I am having 8 standard dimensions in it. One is HSP underscore rates, accounts, period, year, scenario, version, currency, and entity. So you are having 2 extra dimensions. One is currency dimension and the other one is HSP underscore rates dimension. Deenki difference entante HSP rates and currency dimensions are extra added from back end. Okay, now let us go to front end. If you want, you can note it down. Currency dimension will be having 8 standard dimensions. Non currency application will be having only 6 standard dimensions. You will be having 2 extra dimensions in currency. Now, let us go to Asia currency application and look into dimensions from front end. From front end, if I see, I will be able to see only 7 dimensions. I will not be able to see HSP underscore rates dimension. So, your HSP underscore rate dimension is available from back end only. From SBS level only, you can look. From front end onwards, you can see only 7 standard dimensions. Your account dimension, currency dimension, entity dimension, period dimension, scenario dimension, version dimension, and year dimension. So the extra dimension that you see from front end is currency dimension. If I go to Asia application, in Asia application I'll be able to see only 6 standard dimensions. If I select this, I'll be able to see 7. We have a currency option. You see, we'll be having an extra dimension. Now let us go into each and every dimension and try to add a member, and we'll see what all differences we will be getting. So first I'll start with non-currency application. In non-currency application, let me take an account dimension, and in this if I say add child. So now I am adding a child by name called as account 001. AC underscore 001 is the account that I am going to create. So whatever alias you want, you can create here. And if you see, there is an extra property it is asking, account type. In your account types, if you see, you have expense, revenue, assets, liabilities, equities, and saved assumption. So in SBase, what we used to do, we used to create separate headings. But right now, what they have given, they have a predefined expense type, a predefined revenue type, a predefined asset type, and a predefined liability type, and predefined equity type. So what is this saved assumption? Saved assumption is one which doesn't fall under this five types. Under this five types of accounts, expense can be, revenue can be, liability can be, assets can be, equities can be, we call them as saved assumptions. So what type of accounts can be saved? If I ask you to have headcount, number of people in your organization, will that be an expense account? Will that be a revenue account? Will that be an asset account? Will that be a liability account? Will that be an equity account? Will not be all of this, but it will be a saved account. If I ask you to write number of missionaries in your organization, so then also they will fall under your saved account. Because whichever property you don't want to convert to your reporting currencies, or you don't want to perform calculations on it, currency calculations on it, we tag them as saved assumptions. They will not be converted. Say if I am sending 10 people from India, they will not be multiplied by 55. 10 people from here going to America, they cannot become 55 after 5,500. So that way we will tag them as saved assumptions. So, if I am tagging an account as expense, the next property that we have is variance reporting. In SBase, where do we see this variance reporting? This is your variance reporting. If I go into account dimension, I'll get this expense report, right? The same expense reporting in your planning application is displayed like this, variance report. So if I tag expense, automatically this account is tagged as expense. If I tag this account as revenue, automatically it is becoming non-expense. If I tag this account as assets, this is also a non-expense account. If I tag this liability, it is also a non-expense account, in case equity or sales option. Only for your expense accounts, whichever accounts are tagged as expense, by default your variance reporting will become expense. You need not change this property, it is inherited. Fine. The same way, I have selected expense and now I am able to see my time balance properties. If you see at your time balance properties, in SBS we have only three time balance properties, EB first, last and average. But when you come to planning, you will be able to see somewhere around six or seven time balance properties. One is flow, first, balance, average, fill, weighted average actuals underscore actuals, weighted average actuals underscore 365 days. These are the time balance properties that are available. Fill is a property which is added in your 11 version. We didn't have this particular option in your 9.3.1. So this has been added new. Flow is nothing but your TB none property. The data just flows. TB none is nothing but flow. First is nothing but TB first. Balance is nothing but TB last. Average is nothing but TB average. Fill will work when your member is a dynamically calculated member, and if it has a formula, then only your fill works. And this weighted average actuals underscore actuals is considered when you are having 366 days. And weighted average underscore actuals underscore 365 days is used when you are having 365 days. Mostly out of this, we will be using flow, balance first. Very frequently we do this. So now if you see by default for an expense account, what is tagged? So let me say revenue, and let me set it to expense. By default it is set as flow. For expense or for revenue your time balance property is set as flow. Means time balance property is none. On which accounts? Expense and revenue accounts. Because these are P&L accounts, right? If you P&L accounts property, your time balance property is none. Say for example, if I tag this as asset, by default it will become TB last or nothing but balance. Assets, liabilities, equities. But what about your saved assumptions? If you see your saved assumptions, your time balance property will be flow. Okay? And at the same time, you have skip properties. What types of skip properties we have? Skip num. So, on this particular saved assumptions, your calculations will not run. Your calculations will not run. So, most of the times, it will not even calculate 1 plus 2 plus 3. Okay? So your time balance property will be flow on your saved assumptions. Okay? So methodology you can change it later. You can change it to last also. Sometimes when you want to have a last value, but by default your planning application will give. Now the month last month users are. How much headcount is there in my quarter? So we have to pick last month value. At that time you can put balance. But by default you get is flow. Right? Okay. So and apart from that, you have skip properties. What types of skip properties will be having? Skip none, skip zero, skip missing, skip both. So now, if I select my expense account, I will not get my skip properties because it is flow. Or revenue, I will not get this. But if it is assets, I will get my skip properties. Whatever you want, you can skip it. You can skip to missing, zero, missing and zero, both you can skip. Fine. For balance sheet accounts, we can achieve this. Balance, average, and apart from that, sorry, for assets I can get this, revenue I can get this, sorry, liabilities I can get this, equities I can get this, but for saved assumptions I will not get this skip properties. So weighted skip properties also only for balance sheet accounts. Assets, liabilities and equities you will be getting this skip properties. Apart from this, if you see, if I am selecting my expense and if you see your exchange rates, this particular exchange rates are none because this is a non-currency application. And apart from this, two-pass calculation you can enable, and by default your data storage property is never shared, but in case this it used to be stored data, but here by default a member storage property is never shared for your account dimension. Okay, and apart from that, into this plan type what should be the consolidation property? Addition, subtraction, multiplication, division by, percentage, ignore, never. Edi kavalante okati. Right now we want to add it. And apart from this, the last thing that we are not going to discuss source plan types because we have only single source plan type, that is SAL source type. And we are not going to discuss smart list right now. And data type, your data type can be unspecified, currency, a non-currency data, percentage related data, a smart list related data, date related data, or it can be a text also. By default your account dimension data is a currency data. Now when I say save, this particular account is getting created under this. Now let us create it into your currency application. When I say currency application, the difference that we see is when I say add change, you will get all same accounts 01. So let me tag it as expense, flow, never share, but the extra thing I am getting is exchange rate type. This is the difference that we have. You can have exchange rate types, no rate can be defined. No rate will be defined for your saved assumption. If you see, it is set to no rate because it should not be converted. So no rate will be set to your saved assumptions, but for expenses, whatever you want. For expense it is average, for revenue it is average, but for assets it will be ending value, and at the same time liabilities also it will be ending value, and equities also it will be ending value. Time balance, your balance sheet accounts will have ending rate and your P&L statements will have average rate. You will be considering average exchange rate times. But how many types of exchange rates you will have means you can take no rate, average rate, ending rate and historical rate. You can consider historical also. Okay, so by default when I select expense, my type is average rate. Average rate is considered, and apart from this, in this we see two different types of databases. Now because this is an expense account, it has to be recorded only into my expense database. It should not flow into my revenue database. So what I do, I uncheck this. Means account 001 will be available only in Asia expense database, but it will not be available in Asia revenue database. At the same time, addition, subtraction, you can define this. Okay, and the type is currency. That's it. Clear on this? Only different things that we see is here number of plan types have increased, and at the same time what you want to be a plan type, a plan type like bond, into which plan type it has to flow, we have defined that, and apart from that exchange rates also we have to consider. Right? So this means I have created an expense account in both the things. Now let me quickly create add a sibling 00, sorry, 2, and this will be a revenue account. And this revenue will flow only into my revenue database, and that's it. Okay. After that, I'm adding a sibling account 003, which is not revenue and which is not expense. It is a asset account. So this particular asset has to flow into both the databases. When it is flowing into both the databases, on which database user will be locking and sending the data? That we have to define. Source plan type. Source plan type, where will user lock and send it? He will be locking send on expense database. So either he can lock and send on expense or revenue based on your selection. I'll select expense. User should be able to lock and send this data only on expense. and this data will be dynamically available through XRF on your revenue database. Yeah? In revenue database, you will not be able to input on this account 00. Where you can input? You can input in expense database. Okay, this is the new thing that you are seeing. Okay, it is flowing to both the plan types. Same as add a sibling 004. So it is also a liability account which is flowing to both the databases, but into this database it is going as an addition and into this it is going as subtraction. And I say while creating itself we have defined, right? Plan type 1, plan type 2 we have selected. If you want 3, we will be selecting 3. So number of plan types that you can create in a planning application is, how many plan types we can create? 3 plus 2, 5 plan types, because capital expense and headcount also we can. Now next thing is add sibling EAC underscore 005. So this I am going to make it as equity, and this is going as addition. Both two databases it is going as addition. Okay. And the last account that I am going to create is 006, and this is nothing but saved assumption. It is going into both the databases. Now I have created the metadata into my account dimension. So this is how we get. So right now, this particular information, where it is available? It is not available in my SBS application. It is available only in your RDBMS. See, if you see, you don't have any members under this account related members. Where it is getting stored? If I want, you can close this application, and even if I open, this will be there as it is. Because these are getting stored into your relational database. So if this data has to be pushed to your SBS database, means what you will be doing? Administrator, manage database, instead of create, what you say, refresh. This metadata will be flowed to that particular. Now let us go into the dimensions and let us complete the currency dimension. Next dimension we have is currency. We have currency in this, but we don't have currency in your non-currency application. Directly we have entity. This is the difference that we have. So let us look into your currency application now and complete about your currencies. So your reporting currency is USD currency. Now I want to add three more currencies, new currencies. What I'll say? Add. So available or registered currencies are available. So AED, UAE dinar, AFN Afghanistan, Lake, Armenian Dram, Netherlands, Kauzen, all these currencies are available, whatever currencies you want. But I want Canada dollar and I want GBP, Euro, GBP and INR. Can I say? Hello? అవునండి, నేను క్లాస్లో ఉన్నా, కొంతసేపు ఉండండి, లైక్ 1 hour తర్వాత. ఓకే, సో ఐ హవ్ యాడెడ్ దిస్ కరెన్సీస్. బట్ ఇఫ్ యూ సీ యువర్ క్యాడ్, యూరో, జీబీపీ అండ్ ఐఎన్ఆర్ ఆర్ నాన్ రిపోర్టింగ్ కరెన్సీస్. ఓన్లీ యువర్ యూఎస్డీ ఈజ్ ఎ రిపోర్టింగ్ కరెన్సీ. అంటే ఆల్ దీస్ కరెన్సీస్ ఆర్ గెటింగ్ కన్వర్టెడ్ టు యుఎస్. ఇఫ్ ఐ వాంట్ సమ్ ఆఫ్ ద కరెన్సీస్ టు బి కన్వర్టెడ్ టు క్యాడ్, వాట్ ఐల్ సే? ఎడిట్, మల్టిపుల్ సెలెక్షన్స్ అవుతుంది, ఐల్ సే ఎడిట్ అండ్ ఐల్ మేక్ మై రిపోర్టింగ్ కరెన్సీ. హియర్ ఇఫ్ యూ సీ ది రిపోర్టింగ్ కరెన్సీ యాజ్ పాజిటివ్, ఐల్ చెక్ దిస్ రిపోర్టింగ్ కరెన్సీ. ఇఫ్ ఐ చెక్ దిస్, వాట్ హ్యాపన్స్? యూ విల్ హ్యావ్ టూ రిపోర్టింగ్ కరెన్సీస్ ఇన్ దిస్ పర్టికులర్ అప్లికేషన్. యుఎస్డీ అండ్ క్యాడ్ విల్ బి ద రిపోర్టింగ్. Okay, so this is about your currency dimension, and if you see the property of your currency dimension, it is store data. Account dimension it is never share, and storage property for your currency dimension is store data, stored member will be there. Okay. Now let us look into entity dimension. And in Asia dimension, in Asia application, if I create my new entity, add chain, I'll give my entity name India. But in this, storage property is never shared. But if you see the base currency, though the currency in India is INR, because this is a non-currency application, I can select only one currency in this. I'll select USD. And here, data type is unspecified. But in your account, it is a currency type of data. Okay, let us see. Now, let us go into your currency application and create an entity. Actually, India. I can select my Indian currency. INR is my Indian currency. This is the difference that you see. And you can make the currency flow into different databases. If you don't want that to flow into your expenses, you can remove it. But we want to make them flow into two databases. Same way, it may add quickly some other dimensions. Say I want to add US. USD is my functional currency. Save. Add sibling. Canada, it is nothing but CAD, and save it, add sibling, Europe, it is nothing but Euro, save, and add sibling. Finally, what we have, UK. UK is nothing but GB. So this way, say if I add a member under India, what will be the currency under it? By default, if I say add chain, by default my currency will be INR, inherited. Say same way, if I add a member under Canada, sorry, add chain, CAD will be the default, inherited will be applied. Okay, so this is how you can create your members in your entity dimension. But the difference that you see is different currencies can be selected in your currency application, and in your non-currency application you can select only one currency. So altogether you will be having only this much difference between your currency and non-currency. Other things will remain the same. Okay. Now let us go into period dimension. If you go into your period dimension, by default your year total is created, and you cannot delete your big balance members. And you cannot delete your base members. You cannot delete this quarter one. If you see, you cannot, not getting any delete option. You cannot delete them. But if I want to add a member under this, add child, I can add it and I can delete it. Add a child and I can delete that particular option. Okay? So the base things you cannot delete. Can we delete the period dimension members? You cannot delete that. See, your delete option is disabled. Because these are the base members, you cannot delete. And after doing this, so mostly your period dimension members are. Let us see how they look like. Edit. And if you see, the storage property is stored. So, prasthaniki, currency and your period dimensions are stored, but your entity and your account dimensions are never stored, never shared. And both the members, this particular members will flow into both the databases. They cannot flow into a single database. Okay, if you want to enable dynamic time series, you can enable it from here only. DBS space, we have dynamic time series, right? The same option can be enabled from here. Okay? Okay, this is about your period dimension. Scenario dimension. Here you will have a slight change in your scenario dimension. If you see in the scenario dimension, already a member is there, correct? If you want, you can keep it or you can delete it. I'll explain this start year, start period, start end year, end period, I'll explain them later. But you have exchange rate tables in this non-currency application. This particular thing will be disabled, will be available, but still you cannot use it. Here, non-currency application. Enable I am doing, but there is no use because you cannot add that particular exchange rate day. This should be enabled mostly, but still it is enabled. Okay, so this is the slight difference that we see in scenario diversion. Rendiplo enabled, right? In both the applications, currency and non-currency, they will be enabled. But in non-currency application, you cannot create exchange rate tables. Okay, so this is about your scenario dimension. Okay, the last dimension that you have is version dimension. Till now, we didn't have this version in your SDS application. So, if you talk about your versions, versions are of two types. So, you can have two types. Version 1 is nothing but you can call it a standard bottom-up version, and there is another version called as target version. So what are these versions? Standard target version and standard bottom-up version. Bottom-up version user, whoever has access to this bottom-up version, can input data only on level 0 members. Whereas if you select standard target version, user can input data both in top parent levels and bottom levels. Level 0 members they can input, level 1 they can input, level 2 they can input. At whatever level they want, they can input to standard target version. These are the two different types of versions we have in our plan. Version security we will discuss when we come to security. Right now, whoever user is having access to only bottom up version, he can input numbers only on level 0 members. And whoever user is having access to target version, he can input both on level 0s and target versions. Okay? Right now, let us create another version, say target, and define him as standard target. Okay? And say save. Okay? Now, let us go back to scenario. Delete this existing member and create a new scenario. Add child and say actuals, and in this I'll say my actuals are in year 12 and at the same time January FY06 12, and the open month should be till December. Actual should be entered between this period. So this is in non-currency application. Let us go to our currency application. In currency application also, let us delete this. And if I say add chain, I'll be able to see only 1 year in this. Why? Because I'm having only 1 year. I have selected only 1 year. Let us quickly go to years and add some years in it. Year dimension, add years. How many years you want to add? I want to add 10 years. That's it. So 2000. I'll be having my years. Now we come back to scenario, and in this add child actual. So actuals are opened only for a period of FY12 and for a month of, right now the month is July, right? Almost completely. And for the month of July should be the last month. Only this period will be open. I'll show you the significance later. And I'll say save. Same way, if I talk about my budget, budget is also opened from FY12 January, but it is open till FY15 because it is a long term period. So I'll say December, and I'll say and I'll add forecast. Forecast is a short period. Say I'll be adding FY12 Jan to, and say FY12 December. This is my forecast. So this is how I have added three numbers, and at the same time let us add a version in this saying that target version. Now after creating all these things, what I'll do, administrator, manage database, refresh. Go into your SDS application, close this. So let me open my expense. If you see your account dimension, you are having 1, 3, 4, 5, 6. But you are not having two accounts because it was a revenue account. Where is that revenue? That revenue is available in this outline. If you see, this is having 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. But you don't have 1 because it was an expense account. This is how you can restrict your account flow. And at the same time, you have selected in this particular outline as source. These are the source members. So you have a storage property called as membership. But if you go to this outline, to the revenue outline, if you see, the storage property is dynamic calc in nature and you have a formula on this. What is this formula? This is nothing but at the rate of XREF. XREF is used to extract data from different SPSS databases. You can pull data from different SPSS databases because this is a different SPSS database. From this database, if I want to pull my data into this database, then I'll be using this XREF. I'll explain this XREF later. Okay? So, and apart from this, so the source plan type will have never share member and the target plan type will have dynamic calc members with a XREF function. So these are the differences. And one more difference that you will be seeing is when you see into your currencies, how many currencies we have selected? We have selected four currencies: USD, INR, GBP, Euro and Canada. But if you see, you will be having only two currencies. One is local and one is US. Why this? Because your local currency is nothing but all your four currencies. Which currencies? Including your USD, Canada, GBP, UR, all they fall under local currency. They are local for which entity? This local is local for your entity. Where is this entity? Okay. If I am inputting in India, I will be inputting across local. India, local. Same ways, US, local. Same ways, Canada, local. Same ways, Euro, local. Same ways, UK, local. But how will it understand whether I am inputting INR, USD, GBP? It will be understanding based on your HSP underscore input currencies and it will be understanding based on the UDA that you are using. If you see the UDAs are defined, UDAs, US, USD, Canada, CAD, Euro, EU, based on this it will understand what the currency is. But the total data will be booked in this dimension across local currency. Then what will your USD have? Converted currency will only be available on your USD. And at the same time, if you see under your HSP rates, you are able to see HSP rate of Canada, HSP rate of Europe, HSP rate of GBP, HSP rates of USD and INR. So whatever whatever exchange rates you are going to define, say Indian rupee should be converted by 55 rupees. 55 rupees will be equal to $1. So how will that be converted? Where will that be, that value stored? And that value will be stored in your HSP rates underscore INR. In the combination of HSP rates underscore INR, you will be having your exchange rates. Same ways, Canada rate will be stored in Canada, Europe rate will be stored in Europe, GBP rate will be stored in GBP, USD 1 will be stored because it has to be multiplied by 1. $1,000 equals to $1,000. How will you get that? 1000 into 1 is 1 value will be stored. So this is about your dimensions. This is the difference that you are going to see. By default, you are defined with account PDF. So with this we will stop for today and tomorrow we will see how to create web forms. After creating your web forms, again your web forms are of three types: symmetric web forms, asymmetric web forms, composite web forms. After defining these three web forms, we will go into currency conversions. How your data should be converted from local to USD. Okay, once that is done, once the currency conversion is done, almost your planning application is done. After that, we can look into some of the things like your task list, menus, user variables, smart list, manage properties, dimensions almost we have completed. Copy data, clear cell level details, alias tables, reporting, view statistics, applications, settings. But in this, if you see this create application, if I click on this, where will it go? It will go into your application creation tab. Okay, let us take this into consideration. So, if I click on create application, take to this area. You know this area already, right? When will we get this area? When you have a free data source. So, if I want to create a data source, if you see there is an option called as manage data source. In this, if you want to create a data source, I can create a data source. It will automatically display your data source. But if you are an administrator, then only it will show this option. So you are familiar about creating applications. If you want to delete any application, you can delete application. And this register application is nothing but whenever, if you don't find any application in your dropdown, when you are logging in, admin user application. If you are not able to see that particular thing, what you need to do is you need to do a register application. Log into an existing application as an administrator and register that application. Deleting, creating, you know, and the same way manage data source. Create your data source. Existing data source you can edit it or you can delete. So I think we need not discuss about this particular options. So all these options are done. Copy document link not used in this particular application. And user management, when I click on this, automatically it will open my shared services. It will open my shared services. From here itself I can log into my shared services. This is my shared services, right? So this is used for your shared services login. Single sign-on, right? If you are logged into this, automatically you can log in into your shared services. So this is your user management. Data load administration is not used in this. So we don't use this copy document link and data load administration. Okay? So what are the things that are left means we have to discuss about your currency conversion, exchange rate, security filters, and we have to discuss about application settings, view statistics, reporting, alias, clear cells, dimensions we are done, manage properties, smart list, user variables, task list. But tomorrow we will be starting on this data points. So the remaining things are this. And apart from this, we have to discuss about business rules and we have to discuss upon workflow. Total somewhere around 10 topics are there. If we complete this 10 topics, it's almost done. So tomorrow we'll completely concentrate on creation of your data forms and currency conversions. Okay, we'll stop for today. Everything we have to manage from here on. So stopping order is, how will we stop them? First we'll stop this for 3 seconds. RMI registry. Shared services. Finally, opening. With this, I'll stop on the solution. Right click and start. It has to start. Start out the talk about the administrator availability. Need not go into the details. So I think I can close this. Now I get a network error because I have stopped all my SBase servers and this is connected to my SBase server. If your network service go down, means if your SBase services go down, this is the error you will be getting. Unable to connect to Verma 1423. 1423 is your SBase port, starting port number. Focus. Now I can shut it down. Let this run for some time. Let it come to normal. Here's